Hello, and today we are with Mr. Peter Jacops, who is the founding member of Disabled Sailing Thailand. Good morning to you, Peter.
Good morning to you. How are you?
Very well, thank you. Now, here we are. We're sat in Jomtien, Pattaya, Thailand, on the final day of the Ocean Marina Pattaya Boat Show. How has the show been for Disabled Sailing Thailand?
For Disabled Sailing Thailand, it's been a great success. I mean, we're extremely happy as we had the announcement from Ocean Marina Property and Ocean Marina that they're buying 8 boats for Disabled Sailing Thailand. So we're gonna have a huge fleet of SV14s here at Ocean Marina, which is absolutely fantastic.
Now we're going to come back to that, but before we do, what is Disabled Sailing Thailand?
Well, Disabled Sailing Thailand started about 5 years ago when it was announced that disabled parasailing, as we call it, which is not the para boats but Paralympic sailing, was cancelled from the Paralympics. And I thought, well, that's disgusting, because I know that sailing for those people is the only way they can feel really free. When they're underwater, they don't have a wheelchair, they have total freedom of movement, just like you and me. And taking that away from them, at least at a competitive level, is really inhumane. I found it absolutely impossible thing to be. So I discussed it with a few friends here at the marina. Scott Finson was one of the first as well with us. And we said, we got to do something about it, because we looked around and there was nothing in Thailand. Thailand is supposed to be the mecca of sailing. And you have parasailing in Indonesia and Philippines and Hong Kong, Singapore, Malaysia, everywhere except Thailand. So, well, let's start Disabled Sailing Thailand. And so we all put some money on the table to register the organization. And that was it. Disabled Sailing Thailand was born. The next step was to buy boats. That was a bit more complicated. That's a different chapter.
When did you establish Disabled Sailing Thailand? When was it established?
That was about 5 years ago.
And of course, it's not easy. What challenges have you faced in starting and getting people to understand what it is you're all about? And are you a non-for-profit, not-for-profit? I know when it comes to charities, there's a little bit of confusion there sometimes.
We are definitely a not-for-profit organization. I wish we could make some profit, but we're definitely a charity organization. We work entirely with volunteers. And yeah, there's obviously the challenge is to find sponsors. Boats are an expensive thing to buy and to run. There's a whole logistic behind it, going on the water. Of course, we need rescue boats to be present. We need life jackets. There's a lot of things around it. It's not just like a basketball game or something where you buy a ball and you go playing. So there's a lot of logistic that needs to be achieved.
Now the boats, how many boats do you have today?
Well, the story with the boats is that when we started Disabled Sailing Thailand, we started looking at what was available on the market. A disabled boat is not something you find on the internet, on the local market, you know. So you can find some, but they'll be like overseas or so, because it's not a common product. It's a very specific boat that needs to comply with very high stability requirements, safety requirements, ease of use for the different, because every disability needs an adaptation on the boat. So it's quite complicated, and we started chopping around and we thought, okay, we need about 5 boats at least to be a bit of a club. And the prices were outrageous. It's something we really couldn't afford here. So, and we couldn't find any second hand at that time. And I've been in the boating industry myself for 20 years professionally. And I thought, let me look around within my designer's friends, if somebody could maybe help me design one. After all, the King of Thailand built his own boat. Why can't we do it if he did it? So I wrote to, I don't know, 20, 30 designers I know. And Alex Simonis from Simonis Vogt, which is Alex Simonis and Martin Vogt, They are Dutch designers, well known from the leopard cats and so. They replied immediately, within seconds, and they say, "Peter, we'll take up the challenge." I say, "You do realize that I'm not paying you, because designers tend to be very expensive." They say, no, it's fine. We think we come at a stage in our life that it's time to give back something to the industry. We've been in the industry your whole life, and now it's time to give back. We're gonna help you design a new boat. So I'm quite often in Cape Town. I met Alex Simonis, who lives in Cape Town there, together with Russell Vollmer, which is a Paralympian sailor, very good sailor. And we sat around the table and we made the first sketches of what the SV14 would become. That stands for Simonis Voigt. And it took us about two and a half years of development to make the drawings, the calculations. We made a tremendous number of calculations, of simulations on the computer to make sure that the stability and everything was absolutely at the top level. And we came with a design initially in plywood, where we said everybody that wants to download the drawings for free can just download the drawings and build their own boats. And that's how it started. We stood here at the boat show with a bunch of planks, that's all I could call it the first year, and presenting what had to become a boat. And then Gulul Alvani from Royal Phuket Marina came around and he said, "What is this?" I said, "Well, that's supposed to become a boat, and that's for disabled sailors. And here's one of the lady that's a disabled sailors, Nina. Nina is a paraplegic and she can only move her head. That's all she, the only movement she can do." I said, "Well, she can't sail a boat." I said, "Yes, she can, but we need the funding to finish the boat and we'll make it fully servo control so she can move with her chin and with blowpipes and control everything." He said, "That's amazing. How much do you need?" So I said, "How much we needed for the boat?" And he said, "I'm buying it." So that was the start. And a little bit later, Simpson Marine came and they say, "We're doing one too." And the ball got rolling. So then Ostheim Marine built one boat and it went on, and the boats got built all over the world. They built in New Zealand, in California, in South Africa, in Belgium, in Holland, all over the world. They're now being built. And that was the start of the story.
And
short.
But no, but that's fascinating. And we, when we started this interview, you said that Ocean Marina here have just purchased, I believe, eight. Now, what are those boats?
Well, we found out that the plywood version, although give magnificent boats as we have there and so, but it takes time to build. It takes volunteers to build them, or yards. We not always have so much time available. So we decided to come up with a glass fiber version. And we were extremely lucky that Far East Yachts in Shanghai, they came in and they said exactly the same. "We have sold thousands of boats, mainly the Optimist. They're well known for their Optimist. And for 20, 30 years, we've made big money in the industry. It's time to give back. We like your concept. We're gonna build your price at material cost price," which is amazing. They investing a fortune in this project, and now we can offer those boats at really the price of the materials, which is really low. And so came the glass fiber version. And when Ocean Marina heard about that possibilities to buy the boats directly from the factory, they said, "We're joining you. We're gonna order 8 boats." And that's what they announced on Friday. And for Thailand, not only for Thailand, but for the whole of Asia, it's a huge, huge development. The people were here from the Paralympic Committee. They're extremely enthusiastic about the development, because now we have a boat that's affordable, that's been conceptualized in Asia, and will be distributed all over Asia at a really, really low price. Yeah.
Those 8 boats, where will, as you say, eventually some of them will be distributed around Asia, but will those 8 boats stay here in Thailand? What are those plans for those 8 boats?
The 8 boats will remain at Ocean Marina. That will be the Ocean Marina fleet. Of course, I'm already busy in Phuket as well to set up a team in Phuket. I hope to hear actually today if one boat is going through, it's a start. And so that's going to be fun because we're going to have Phuket and Pattaya. There's going to be this competition feeling, and so that's going to make it even more attractive. We're going to have the first competition at the top of the Gulf, where we'll have a, for the first time, there will be a parasailing group participating at the top of the Gulf. So that's huge development for Asia, for Thailand.
Well, how do you envisage the Phuket chapter, if you like, of, mm-hmm. of Disabled Sailing Thailand being different from the one here in Pattaya?
No, you rightly say it's a chapter. Disabled Sailing Thailand is registered at Ocean Marina, actually. That's even our physical address. Phuket's going to become a chapter. And yeah, it's the idea to run exactly the same concept, have a local competition there, and then a few times a year we'll be able to have national competition between Phuket and Pattaya, and then Southeast Asia competition, of course, with Singapore and Hong Kong and all the nations around.
You're starting with Thailand. Do you have any plans for any other chapters in Thailand itself?
Yes, sure. We are looking at different places in Thailand at the moment. Who are in and other places are coming to mind. But yes, it is the concept to have all little group. Even if they have only one boat, it doesn't matter. That makes it exciting to be able to compete against each other. Yeah.
Now, how many members do you have? Because of course, sailing, some able-bodied people are put off by sailing because of the dangers involved. Mm-hmm. Maybe they can't swim. Of course, if you're a paraplegic, there's very real danger, immediate danger, if you were to fall into the water.
Yep.
How many members do you have? And yes.
Well, at the moment, we have about five sailors that are really under training. They are being trained by the Royal Varuna Yacht Club. They give the courses. Two of them have already been to America to the World Championship, where they did a very good result. I'm very proud of them. And the people in America and the trainers there were very impressed by what they did, considering that they just started sailing. We went with another two sailors to Japan to a clinic. And they also really enjoy that part. So most of them are from the Father Ray Foundation, and they're queuing there. They're queuing. So eight boats, each boat has two seats. That means we can have 16 sailors now, plus the boat from Simpson, plus the boat from Royal Phuket. So we can now have easily 20 sailors to be in the team, which is absolutely great.
From a safety perspective, how does it work? Because if you are a paraplegic or if you have a disability that might stop you from being able to swim or stay afloat, mm-hmm. How does the safety aspect work of this?
Of course, the safety aspect is the most important item of our boat. That's the one we've done the most research on. As I said, we worked with world-renowned naval architects. I'm myself a marine surveyor. We did a lot of research, testing on the water with the boat, simulation on the computer. The boat has a 107 kilo keel, which is 1 meter down, to ensure that the stability of the boat, even under extreme condition, is always guaranteed. Of course, all the sailors will have life jackets. Yesterday we got a whole box of life jackets donated by Tonsan Marine, and we will always have a rescue boat going with. They cannot go out without a rescue boat. That's really ultimate safety requirement.
Now, a lot of people will be watching this thinking, okay, Disabled Sailing Thailand, you are from Belgium originally. Are Thai people involved with this project?
Yes, actually, I found out that, like, on the boat shows, we actually have a lot of response from the Thai people. They very much appreciate it. Of course, the Paralympic Committee is very much supporting us. The boat that was built by Thai Marine being donated to Her Majesty, the Princess Sirinhorn. So she received the boat, which is then again donated again to the charity. So there's that role aspect where we have a lot of support behind, and yes, they really love what we're doing. It's for them, of course, and we hope it develops.
Now, I'm sure there's a lot of people in the hotel industry, aviation industry, watching this, thinking, how can we get involved? This is something that we would like to support. How can hotels or owners of whoever they are get involved and support you?
All right, so the program we have is a three-year sponsorship. Ocean Marina actually run that program. So it's a three-year sponsorship where you have your full branding on the boat. Ocean Marina will take care of the maintenance and everything and ensure that they participate in all regattas, and you have your full branding, your full mention in the press and everywhere, and it's a sponsorship package that's offered.
Right, and are there different levels that you can come in at, or is there, I mean, if you're possibly not as rich as other people, can you donate small amounts, or do you have to go for a boat?
Look, we appreciate everything. I mean, like yesterday we received those life jackets. We really need them. You know, I always say everybody can help. I hate it when somebody comes to our stand and say, well, I don't have time. First of all, it's hard to believe. I'm working full time. I still can find time. If you don't have time, you have a bit of money. If you don't have money, yes, maybe you have a restaurant. Maybe you can say, bring a few of your sailors to have a nice lunch for one day, you know, there's always something you can do. Just contact us and I'm sure I'll find something how you can help us.
That's good to hear. In Phuket, you're just launching in Phuket. Where is that going to be?
We're working between the Royal Phuket Marina, of course, where we would keep the boat and hopefully get the support and the volunteers from the Phuket Yacht Club to man the operations.
Accessible travel is something which is talked about a lot at the moment in the industry. If people are disabled and going to Phuket on holiday or coming here to Pattaya, are they able to take a boat out as well?
We are working on that plan, yes, that they would be able to come out on the boat. That's the logistics, of course, that we have to work on, because as I said, we have to ensure the safety first and for all. So to get a boat out, that means you also need a rescue boat, and that's also need the manning. So yes, that is the future plans, to be able to have visitors from other clubs, of course, outside Thailand, to come and participate, but baby steps.
Well, Peter, I have to say thank you very much indeed for your time today and all the hard work that you are doing for this very good cause. And so thank you. And I do wish you and Disabled Sailing Thailand the best of luck for the future.
Thank you very much.